Welcome to part 7 of the Sterredeken. We're going to start with the border. The border consists of 3 parts. This is part 7, so we still have 8 and 9 to go. And this side, this part, we're going to start with a lot of single crochets. And we're going to work all around the blanket, of course, to create our border. And for color, I chose the same color yarn that I chose for this middle piece, or the main color of this middle piece, because the border is going to be a little bit similar, or not similar, but also quite open. So I think that's good to have the same color for balance. But of course, you can choose any size, any color. It's all up to you. We're going to start in a corner of. One of the corners, that's the beginning of a long side. So not of a short side, of a long side. And we're going to make in this corner one single crochet, chain 2, and one single crochet. So the corner exists of one single crochet, chain 2, one single crochet. We skip that first hidden stitch. We're just going to ignore it. And we're going to make a single crochet into the next 37 stitches, which are the ones of the square. And I'm just going to show a whole side to you to make sure that you get how to do it. I'm just going to make all these single crochets really quickly. It's not going to take much of your time at all, this first round. Of course, this is for the single bed blanket. If you're making a king size blanket and you already made your, I don't know how many they were, 20 squares, you're not going to do this round because you already did a round of single crochet. So you can just skip this round and just keep going. Make your single crochets very straightforward and just continue until you're on the other side with me of this first little square. I'm almost there. And of course, we're working through both loops, if you were wondering. Just get every stitch like this. Oh, don't work too tight, of course. With single crochets, it's always a danger that you work too tight, so don't do that. Keep working loosely. Now, in the chain space of this square, we make one single crochet. In the stitch where we connected, we make one single crochet. And of course, here it's a little bit of a pushing through because it's not going to be look too nicely, especially if you worked away your ends already like I did. And then we are starting this piece, so the connecting a bit. And we're going to make 3 single crochets into that first double crochet, you could say, like this. And in the second double crochet, we're going to make 2. This we're going to repeat 6 times. And if you have any leftover tails or bridges to get to the other side, just take them along with you so that you can just make them disappear. And we're going to repeat this 3 single crochets here, 2 single crochets here. We're going to repeat that 6 times. So this was 3, this was 2. In the next double crochet, we make 3 single crochets like this. The next one, we make 2. And the next one, we make 3. And in the next one, we make 2, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, And now we're at the other side, almost at the other side. We repeated this six times. Repeated this six times. And now we're just going to repeat the one last time of the two single crochets. So in that last double crochet, make two double crochets like this. Now we've covered this whole connecting bit. And then in the next chain space, which is this chain space of the square, you make one single crochet. Then we're at the big middle piece. And in the big middle piece, we're going to make one single crochet into every 109 stitches. And don't forget that first hidden stitch, which is this one. So don't forget this one. And on the other side, we're going to do exactly the same. We're going to start in the first double crochet, make three single crochets, the next one two, and repeat that until you are at the end of that connecting piece. And just do exactly what I did before, but repeat it in mirror until you get to the other side. And I will see you when we're at the other end for the short side. I just almost finished my 109 stitches or single crochets into the stitches of the middle piece. And I'm going to show you the rest real quick. As you can see, I have two more single crochets to go, so I'll just make them with you. Into the chain space of the square, big square, make one single crochet. Oh. And you make two single crochets into the next stitches, which are these. And as I said, just poke your needle through like this and make two single crochets. Don't worry about it too much. This is just to get the right stitch count for the next round. In the next double crochet or chain space, make three single crochets. One, two, three. And in the next space, make two single crochets. One, two. And of course, we're going to be repeating this again six times. And I'll show you. So this is one, two, three. One, two, one, two, three. Just a little bit more yarn. This was one, two, three. This is one, two, one, two, three, one, two. One, two, three. Yarn is a little bit tangled up. And one, two, three. One, two. So now we've finished our repeats. And in that last chain space, we make one single crochet. Sorry, make two to finish the repeat. Excuse me. Then into this connecting stitch, we make one single crochet. Just again, poke your needle through like this and make a single crochet. Into the chain space of the square, next small square, we're going to make one single crochet. And then into each of the next stitches, we make a single crochet. And we're not going to forget that first hidden stitch, which is really hidden. So really just pull your work apart so you can see it. This is the first stitch, and don't miss that. And just make a single crochet into every single stitch until you're at the end. And I think you can do the short side alone. It's not very hard. You keep going with your single crochets until you get to the corner. In the corner, you make one single crochet chain 2, 1 single crochet, skip that first hidden stitch, and make 1 single crochet into each and every stitch of these squares. That's all there is to the short side, so I don't think I need to show you. Do this for all the sides, and when you're done, we will be back for round 2. Round 2. And we're going to start with any of the short sides, which is one of the sides that has the 3 squares in a row next to each other. If you're doing a big king size blanket, you also do the short side version of this round, because you're just going to follow that for the king size blanket. And for the single size blanket, of course, we're going to have a short, or keep having a short and a long side, so I will show you both. We're going to start into a corner, as usual, and we're starting with a half double crochet in that corner, standing half double crochet, and another one, so 2 half double crochets, chain 2, and a half double crochet, and another one. So your corner is 2 half double crochet, chain 2 half double crochet. We're going to skip that first hidden stitch, and we're going to chain 1. Skipping that stitch, make a half double crochet into the next stitch, that's this one. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch, which is this one, make a half double crochet into the next stitch, and chain 1 again. That's all there is to the short side. So you're going to half double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch, half double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch, into the next stitch, make a half double crochet, chain 1. That's what you're going to do this round, or this side, like this. Chain 1, skip a stitch, into the next stitch, half double, like this. This is what you're going to do until you're at the end. And when you're at the end, I will show you how to do the long side. As you can see, I've just finished my short side. I'm all the way to the end. And I'm going to work into the corner now. And the corner is exactly the same as the other side. We're going to make 2 half double crochets, chain 2, and 2 half double crochets. Like this. Skipping the first 2 stitches, which is the first hidden stitch, this one and this one, we're going to chain 1, skipping these 2 stitches, and make a half double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1, skip a stitch, and make a half double crochet. Chain 1, skip a stitch, and make a half double crochet. And basically, we're going to do exactly the same that we did in this short side. We're going to do the same with the long side. We're just going to chain 1, skip a stitch, and make a half double crochet into the next stitch until you're at the end of the side, and then just repeat this pattern twice so you get to the other end. Close with a slip stitch on your first stitch, and then I'll see you for round 3. Round 3, we're going to start on the beginning of one of the long sides for your single bed blankets. And so on the long side, not the short side. And we're going to start in the corner with a new color and make 2 single crochets, chain 2, and 2 single crochets. That's our corner. Then we're going to skip those 2 half double crochets from the corner from the previous round, and we're going to make work into round one of this part, which is the black here, which is the single crochets, and we're going to work into this stitch. So we skipped this one and this one, then working into this kind of skipped stitch. We're going to make a double crochet over this chain space like this. I'll show you again. First we're going to make chain two and another double crochet the same way, like this. Then we're going to skip, we're working into round two again, not into round one, and that's this chain space. That's what we're going to work in. I'm going to make one single crochet in there, like this. Very pretty looking way of making a border. Then again, we're skipping all of this and we're working into the next skipped stitch from round one. And we make a double crochet in there, working over that chain space, making a double crochet like this. Chain two, and make a double crochet. Into the next chain space of round two, make a single crochet. And into the next skip stitch over that chain space, make a double crochet. Chain two, and a double crochet, like this. This is basically the pattern. Like, as you can see, it's making nice kind of V's. And we're going to work this stitch 32 times. And after you've done this 32 times, we make chain one. So 32 times should be right in the middle of it. We make a chain one. And then we continue on the same way. So basically we end the number 32, or the last stitch before that chain one, is a single crochet like this. Then we chain one. And then we work another single crochet. So basically we're skipping one of the V's. That's how you could see it. And we're going to not do that here, of course. We're going to do that after we've done 32 repeats of this, so right in the middle. I don't think I need to show you this, it's quite simple. After this chain one space, we're going to make a single crochet here and then continue on with the V's until you're at the end of your long side. Then the corner, you make, of course, two single crochets, chain two single crochets. You skip the two stitches exactly the same way. And again, you start with your repeat, which is exactly the same as here, until you're at the end of the round. So in the short, on the short side, there is no chain one like on the long side. And on the long side, after 32 repeats, you make a chain one and you continue with a single crochet and then your normal repeats. I think you can do this. If not, really just watch this video from the beginning and you should be able to do it. It's not very hard. And then I will see you for round four. Round number four. We're going to start with the beginning of any long side. And I'm already almost there because I'm using the same color. So I'll just slip stitch to the corner, like this. Now I'm in the corner. And we're going to make a different kind of corner than you're used to. We're going to make two V stitches into that corner with a chain two in between. Well, for our first V stitch, of course, we're going to just chain three because we are at the position where we need to chain instead of make a standing stitch. Of course, if you're using a different color, you will use a standing stitch, or if you cut your yarn. So this is our double crochet of the V-stitch, chain two, double crochet. That's our first V-stitch made. Then we're going to chain two and make another V-stitch. So double crochet, chain two, and double crochet. Like this. So it's a little bit of a non-traditional corner, but it's very pretty. So anyway, we're going to skip these stitches of the previous round, and also this one. We're going to work into these chain spaces, and we're going to make a V-stitch in each into each V-stitch. That's how you could see it. So into that chain space, make a double crochet, chain two, and a double crochet. Again, skipping all of these stitches, make a double crochet into the next V-stitch, chain two, and double crochet. Skip these stitches into the chain space, double crochet, chain two, double crochet. Like this. This is what it's supposed to look like. We're going to do this 32 times until we're at that point where you did those single crochet, chain one, single crochet. And let me just look for it. It should be right in the middle of your center bit over here. Here, when we've arrived here, we will have made the 32nd of our V-stitch. You're going to skip this single crochet. So this single crochet, we will skip this one. And then into that chain space, it's this, we're going to make another V-stitch. That's an extra V-stitch. And then we're going to keep going as we were before, make 32 V-stitches into those loops. And that's all there is to this round. After you've arrived at the corner, you make again the same kind of corner. You make a V-stitch, chain two, and a V-stitch, and you skip those first stitches and start into that first V-stitch. Make a V-stitch. Do this 29 times for the short side. So for the long side, it's 32 times. One in the middle, in the chain space between the single crochets, and then 32 more. In the corner, make a V-stitch, chain two, a V-stitch, and on the short side, make 29 V-stitches to get to the other side. When you're done, join with a slip stitch, and I'll see you for round 5. Round number 5. We're going to continue with the same color, or that's what the pattern calls for. Of course, if you want to do anything else, you can do it. But the pattern calls for the same color, so I'll just continue with the same color as well. This is the corner, and this is the V-stitch before it. So I'm going to slip stitch into that next V-stitch, like this. Now I'm at the right position. And we're going to make a chain 5. 1, 2, 3, this is the first double crochet, and chain two, which is chain five, and then make another double crochet into the same chain space. Of course, that's our first V-stitch made, like this. Let's get some more yarn. Okay. Then into the corner, we're going to make one V-stitch, chain two, one V-stitch, like we did the previous round. That's double crochet, chain two, double crochet, chain two, and then to the same space, one double crochet, chain two, and double crochet, like this. This is your first or new corner made. Of course, here we're going to do the same as we did here before, making a V-stitch into that next chain space, which is double crochet, chain two, and double crochet. Like this. Like Now we're just going to do exactly we did the round before. This one, it's not going to change. It's going to be exactly the same. Going to work one V-stitch into every single chain space. So, yarn over, get into that first V-stitch, chain two, and double crochet. Yarn over, into the next chain space, make a double crochet, chain two, and another double crochet. Look for the next chain space, this one, make a double crochet, chain two, and a double crochet. This is all we're going to do this round. So basically the corner is also the same. It's going to be a V-stitch, chain two, and another V-stitch. In the spaces before the corner, we're also going to make a complete V-stitch. And in every chain space, we're going to make a V-stitch as well. And that's all there is to this round. There's not going to be anything else needed to be done. Continue this for all the sides. Of course, on the long side, we have 69 V-stitches when we're done. On the short side, 33. That's the only difference. But the rest is all the same. So just go around, make your V-stitches, and we will see you for round 6, which is also very, very similar. Only the corners are going to change a bit, but I will show you that later. Row number 6. We're going to pretty much just continue the same way like we did before. The only difference that there is that we're going to not make any new corners. We're just going to continue making V-stitches. And I'll show you how to do that. We're already at the right place. We don't need to do anything. We're just going to make a V-stitch into this stitch. And I'll just slip stitch into the next V-stitch to make sure we're in the right position. We're going to chain 3 for our first double crochet, chain 2, and double crochet into the same space. That's our first V-stitch made. In the next V-stitch, make another V-stitch, chain 2, double crochet. And then this is the corner. Normally we would make, or in previous rounds we would make 2 V-stitches and a chain 2 in between. This time we're not going to do that. We're just going to make a normal V-stitch in there and treat it like any V-stitch on the side, like this. And just continue on until the next V-stitch, make another V-stitch in there. This is all we're going to do this round. There's not going to be anything else. In every corner, make one V-stitch. So we're not going to add on any more stitches there. And every chain space of a V-stitch, make another V-stitch. Join onto the third chain of this first chain 3. And then I'll meet you for the last row of this round, which is row number 7. Round number 7. In this round we're basically going to repeat what we already did several times before. So there's not going to be any surprises here. I just joined to this V double crochet, or this V stitch. I'm just going to slip stitch into that to be in the right position. Then I'm going to chain 3 for the first double crochet, chain 2, and make a double crochet. That's your first V-stitch made. Then we make a V-stitch into that next chain 2 space, which is double crochet, chain 2, double crochet, as you probably by now already know. And then we've arrived at the corner. In the previous round we didn't add any stitches there. We didn't do a V-stitch, chain space V-stitch, but this time we're going to. We're going to make a V-stitch in there, like this. going to chain one and make another V-stitch like this. That's your corner made like this. Then all we're going to do is basically, like I said, exactly the same as we did the previous rounds. We're going to look for all those chain two spaces and make a V-stitch in there. A V-stitch is double crochet, chain two, double crochet. One more. Double crochet, chain two, double crochet. And we're going to do this all the way around. There's not going to be anything different. Just make a V-stitch into every single stitch. In the end, all your work will look like this nice mesh here. And when you're done, you join to the third chain that you made in the beginning. And that will conclude our part 7. So we have completed 7 parts of this terra blanket already. And 1 part of the border is just going to be 2 more parts for the border. So just stay tuned and we'll see you for the next part.